Hey everyone, Lio Convoy here. I know I've been gone for a while, but frankly I was busy with work. This video isn't going to be the normal content I cover here, but it is tangentially related since it's part of toy collecting, a subset of 80s kids' lives. This started when my friend Michael at Retroblasting wound up getting a package on his doorstep. The Jabba Sail Barge. It's actually called a katana, but that sounds too close to a weapon that actually has a real purpose. So I'm just going to call it the Barge from here on out. Michael made a video last year decrying Hasbro's piss-poor crowdfunding method of making this toy. So why does he have it, do you ask? Because a gentleman named Brent from Australia couldn't get his US shipper to send it to him, so he planned on donating it to Retroblasting. But Michael is a man of integrity and conviction. This is why we're friends, in fact. So Michael asked for help from the viewers to do the right thing for Brent, to get it to him in Australia. Hours later, a YouTuber by the name of Danoby2 put out a video where he accused Retroblasting of fabricating the entire event so Michael would have a cover for having the barge he was against. You can see my initial reaction here when Michael told me of it. And since it's obvious that Dan here is fond of puppets, I might as well communicate to him in a manner he understands. So Dan put out a hit video of Michael because it hurt his fifis that Michael wouldn't support a toy he wanted. How quaint. He's making this accusation without a shred of evidence on a man who has been consistently honest for the years he's been on YouTube. His integrity is on display at all times. How can I say that, you may ask? Maybe I'm just agreeing with Michael on everything. Well, here's the thing. Michael hates Thundercats. And I am the biggest Thundercats fan on this platform. You can see behind me part of my collection, and I am sticking up for this man. That should tell you something. But it's not enough for Dan to merely mock Brent's existence with a puppet or to baselessly insult Michael. Of course not. He had to make a bigger fool of himself by showing everyone that he doesn't know how words work.
Michael's channel, Retroblasting, spearheaded a campaign to prevent the successful backing of Jabba Sail Barge. Yeah.
For someone who runs his mouth so much about Brent being dumb for expecting his barge to make it to Australia, you've shown a severe lack of understanding on how words work and what they mean. Maybe you and your puppet should go back to Sesame Street. Campaign means work in an organized and active way against a particular goal. Typically a political or social one. This is its second definition. Michael put out one video, you koala-brained idiot. And I say koala-brained as both a nod to Brent's nationality and also to point out the fact that, like a koala, Dan here is smooth-brained. The difference is, while a koala's stupid, at least they're usually cute, whereas Dan is not. And yes, I could sit here all day and mock this cretin's appearance and scrawniness. But that wouldn't be fair, considering Audie Murphy was a World War II vet that stood a towering 5'5", but was such a beast, it makes Guts from Berserk look like a child. No, the main problem with Dan, the nudie reviewing man, is his lack of courage and his inability to be honest. After his first video, Retroblasting responded to the controversy by reaffirming that Brent is getting the barge. Shortly after, Dan released yet another video and makes asinine proclamations while pimping out his merchandise, demanding that Michael do what would satisfy him enough to prove the existence of Brent, and trying to get his followers in on it by offering to give away one of his barges if Michael follows through with his demands. Yeah, about that. Michael doesn't owe a weasel like you anything. While Michael's trying to get this toy to its owner, you sat there snickering and trying to use the situation to your own benefit. You're so upset that this man isn't a corporate shill that you have attacked his character over it. A very unwise thing to do, considering you are a literal thief. But we'll address that later. In The Art of War, it's stated that to win a battle, you must know your enemy and yourself. Seems to me, Dan, you know neither, because if you knew Retroblasting, you'd know that they forced IGN to credit them when one of their writers plagiarized their video for an article. They've issued a C&D to a clown that tried to claim that Michael was a racist, and even made Jedi temples tuck their tails and beg for a ceasefire because they tried to attack Michael after he spoke up about the Barge last year. You lost before you got that puppet out to begin with. And more to the point, when Michael put out a video today and called you out directly, even using your last name, you issued a privacy strike. This could have been because you put in there evidence that you're full of crap by having Brent and people he knows on camera there. Or because you're a puss that doesn't like people knowing who you really are. And that line about you being a puss, I can confirm that directly. Because when I commented on your video offering to host a call between you and Michael, you opted to delete all of my comments from your video. Because you're a coward. And not just a coward, but a liar and a thief. I did say I'm going to get back to that, didn't I? Well, Dan, know this. Your email address is easily accessible on YouTube, a feature you directly allowed. And that's all it takes to do a deep dive on you. But here's where I wreck you, because I'm not going to put any of that on screen, nor will I speak of it in the video directly. But the viewers here can feast their eyes on the pinned comment to see what type of man you really are deep down. Let me make this clear to you. If Michael is like Superman, then I'm Batman. I don't always agree with him, but I've got his back 100%. And unlike Commissioner Gordon, I'm not going to tuck the man down from figuratively strangling the life from you for being a pathetic little weasel. If your alleged concerns were genuine, you could have contacted Michael directly on Facebook or Twitter. Instead, you opted to do what Michael called punching down on a channel smaller than you. Michael's a pretty nice guy, but I'm less so to cowards. And while I, in ways, disagree with Michael's view on punching down, I have no problem punching up. You're a pathetic, worthless weasel. You were stupid, careless, and clumsy, and now the world's going to know about your character in its full. Welcome to the internet, clown. Your sins will find you out. I recommend apologizing to Michael sincerely before this bites you harder than you can ignore. And one more thing before I end this. I know there are people out there who review toys or are in this scene that see what Michael's going through, see the things that have gone on here, all the lies and cowardice that this guy is pulling, and none of you are stepping up to help this man. Specifically, let's take a look at somebody like, say, Pixel Dan, who, despite being shouted at by Retroblasting and shouting them back out in return and showing up in their comment section to defend himself from people who don't like him, I haven't seen you say a word about this, buddy, and there's no way you don't know about it. You're not that quiet, and you're not that small. People like you have got to learn to stop being scared that a corporation won't give you free toys to review, and I use that word lightly, because you don't review, you sponsor them, and learn to find your testicles and your integrity. Now, speaking of integrity, before I end this video, I want to make something else very clear here. I'm not just going to talk out of the side of my mouth. Michael of Retroblasting, I am willing to give you $100 to help this sail barge get to Brent. I am not a Star Wars fan, and I hate the way Hasbro's been handling this, and I hate clowns like Danoby2 who lie. I'm willing to help a fellow toy collector get what he wants. Let me know. For those of you who are here just for the show, I really hope you enjoyed it. I'll be back to my normal stuff shortly. Take care.